ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமஹ சில்ட்ரன். டுடே வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சீ அ சம் அண்டர் த நெக்ஸ்ட் டைப் ஆஃப் குட்வில் வென் த நியூ ஆர் இன்கமிங் பார்ட்னர் இஸ் நாட் ஏபிள் டு பிரிங் ஹிஸ் ஷேர் ஆஃப் குட்வில். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் சம் நம்பர் 34 இன் யுவர் எக்ஸசைஸ். ABC ஆர் இன் அ பார்ட்னர்ஷிப் ஷேரிங் ப்ராஃபிட்ஸ் இன் த ரேஷியோ 5:4:1. Two new partners, D and E, are admitted and the new profit sharing ratio is 3:4:2:1. D is to pay ₹90,000 for a share of goodwill, but he is unable to bring his share of goodwill. Both the new partners introduced ₹1,20,000 each as their capital. You are required to pass necessary journal entry. Sum number 34. First, we will find the sacrifice of the existing partners. So, we'll go to the next page and complete the working notes. So, the first part of working note is to calculate the sacrificing ratio. So, sacrificing ratio is equal to old ratio minus new ratio. Now, we'll calculate sacrifice for A. The old ratio of A, B and C is, the old PSR is 5:4:1 and new PSR is 3:4:2:1. Okay. So now the old ratio of A is 5/10 and the new ratio is 3/12. So just take LCM, you will get 60 and 30 minus 15. 15/60 is the sacrifice made by A. Then next for B, 4/10 minus 4/12. LCM is 60. So you'll have 24 minus 20. So the sacrifice is 4/60. Next for C, 1/10 minus 2/12. Okay. So here you get 6 minus 10, that is -4/60. When you get a negative answer while calculating sacrificing ratio, it means that this partner has also gained. Okay, so only A and B are sacrificing, instead C is gaining with the other new partners. Okay, so now the sacrificing ratio of A and B is 15:4. Now, the goodwill of the firm is given. So, we have to find out how much is the goodwill to be brought in by the new partner E and also the gaining partner C. Okay. So, goodwill of the firm is not given. So, to calculate the goodwill of the firm, what we have to do is take the goodwill which is brought by the new partner D and multiply it with the reciprocal of his profit share. Okay. So 2/12 is his profit share. Now reciprocal of it is 12/2. So just multiply it. You will get ₹5,40,000. Okay. So, this is the goodwill of the firm. Now, we'll calculate how much is C's share of goodwill. So, C's share of goodwill is ₹5,40,000 into how much is his gain. His gain is 4/60. Okay. So, you'll get transfer, you will get 36,000. Yes. Now, the other partner who is not able to bring his share of goodwill, E's share of goodwill is equal to rupees 5,40,000 into 1/12. So you will get rupees 45,000. So now the calculation part is over. We'll move to the journal entry. Journal. Now, the first entry is for the capital brought in by the new partners. So, bank account, debit to the new partners' capital account. Both of them are bringing 1,20,000 each. So, D's capital account, 1,20,000, and E's capital account, 1,20,000. D alone is bringing his share of goodwill. So, to premium for goodwill, account, he is bringing 90,000 as a share of goodwill. Okay. So, the total is 3,30,000. Okay. So, now, being the amount for capital brought in by D and E and premium for goodwill brought by D. Okay, so now next entry is for the compensation. Okay, so here three partners are gaining, two partners are sacrificing. So first we will take the gaining partner. Partner C, who is the existing partner, is also gaining, so he has to compensate. C's capital account, debit. So his share of goodwill is 36,000. Okay. So now is the value of share of compensation to be given by C. And then for the new partner E. So when E is not able to bring, always we will use his current account or we will debit his current account. Okay, so E's current account, debit, and we'll see how much is E's share of goodwill. E's share of goodwill is 45,000. So E's share of goodwill is 45,000, and D has already brought his premium for goodwill. Premium for goodwill account, debit. One minute, I wrote on the wrong side. 36,000, 45,000, and now he has brought 90,000. Okay, now we are compensating this to A and B. So A's capital account to B's capital account. So this we will divide among A and B. We will distribute it among A and B in their sacrificing ratio, that is 15:4. Okay. So A will get 1,35,000 and B will get 36,000. Okay, as the compensation. So the adjustment entry asked for goodwill. Okay, so this is how we have to pass entry when the partner is not able to bring in the amount for goodwill. Next, we are going to see how to find the hidden goodwill. Anil and Sunil are partners in a firm with fixed capitals of ₹3,20,000 and ₹2,40,000 respectively. They admitted Charu as a new partner for 1/4 share in profits of the firm on 1st April 2012. Charu brought ₹3,20,000 as her share of capital. Calculate the value of goodwill and record necessary journal entries. So here, first we have to calculate how much is Charu bringing and what is the amount of goodwill, what is the value of goodwill of the firm, and then we have to find out how much Charu has to bring for her share of goodwill. Okay, so we'll proceed with the answer. Sum number 37. So first we'll complete the calculation of goodwill, then we'll move on to the journal entry. So first, Charu brings her capital. Okay, Charu's capital is how much? ₹3,20,000, and this she is bringing for her 1/4 of share. Okay, so therefore, what is the total capital of the firm? So the total capital of the firm should be the amount when we get by multiplying the capital brought in by the new partner with the reciprocal of the new partner's share. Okay, so she is admitted for 1/4 of profit, and now we are just multiplying, we are reciprocating the profit share and multiplying with the capital brought in by her to find out the total capital of the firm. Okay, so here we'll get ₹12,80,000 as the new capital. But actually, the capital of a partnership firm will be the capital contributed by both the partners. Okay, so here the capital, total capital of partners is ₹3,20,000, ₹2,40,000 plus ₹3,20,000, right? So the total capital of all partners together is ₹8,80,000. So the difference between these two amount is the hidden goodwill. Okay, so this is how we have to calculate hidden goodwill. So hidden goodwill is equal to the total capital which we found out by inversing the profit share of the new partner, that is 12,80,000, and the total capital of the partners have to be subtracted from this amount, 8,80,000. So we will get ₹4,00,000 as the hidden goodwill. Okay, so now we'll move to the journal entry. So the date of admission, date, particulars, debit and credit. Yes. Now, on 2012, April 1, Charu is getting admitted. So for the amount brought in by her as capital and premium for goodwill, we have to pass the first entry. So she has brought rupees 3,20,000 for her capital. Okay. So bank account debit 3,20,000 to Charu's capital account rupees 3,20,000. Now B amount brought in by Charu as capital. Okay. Next, we are going to pass the entry for the compensation paid by Charu. As Charu has not brought in her goodwill amount, we have to debit Charu's current account. Okay. So Charu's current account debit to both the partners are sacrificing here to Anil and Sunil. Okay. As both are following fixed capital account method, we have to credit their current account only. Okay. Because under fixed capital account method, the capital of the partner remains unchanged. All other addition and deletion of the partner's capital account will reflect only in the current account. Okay. So credit Anil's current account and Sunil's current account with equal amount, that is 50,000. So here we have found out the goodwill of the whole firm. So out of this, 1/4 has to be brought by Charu. Okay, because her profit share is 1/4. So 4 lakh into 1/4 will give 1 lakh. Okay. And these two partners are sacrificing equally. So 50,000 will be the compensation paid. Okay. So here the narration being the compensation is credited to Anil and Sun. Okay, so this is how we have to complete this question from goodwill when it is hidden. Okay. Now we will see a comprehensive sum, children. Aman commenced a business with a capital of rupees 2,50,000 on 1st April 2015. During 5 years ended 31st March 2020, the following profits and losses were made. In 16, they had a loss of rupees 5,000. In 2017, they had a profit of rupees 13,000. In 2018, there was a profit of rupees 17,000. In 2019, the profit is 20,000. And in 2020, the profit is 25,000. During this period, he had drawn rupees 40,000 for his personal use. On 1st April 2020, he admitted Bowman into partnership on the following terms. Bowman to bring for his half share in the business, capital equal to Aman's capital, on 31st March 2020 and to pay for the 1/2 share of the goodwill of the business on the basis of 3 times the average profit of last 5 years. Prepare the statement showing what amount Bowman should invest to become a partner and pass entries to record the transactions relating to admission. Okay. So now first we have to find out the goodwill of the firm with the details given in the question. And then we have to find out how much he has to bring for his share of goodwill. Okay? Yes. Sum number 46. So first we will see the working notes. After completing working notes, we'll pass the journal entry. So first we have to find out the goodwill of the firm. Okay, to find out the goodwill of the firm, we have to use the average profit method here. To find out the average profit, add the profits given for 5 years. So we have rupees 13,000 rupees, 17,000 rupees, 20,000 rupees, 25,000, and we have a loss of rupees 5,000, so just minus it. So you will get rupees 70,000 as the average profit. To find out the goodwill, we have to actually consider the average profit, but here we have found out only the total of the profit. Okay, so now to find out the average profit, divide this total profit with the number of years, this 5, so you will get rupees 14,000 as the average profit. Okay, and to value goodwill, to find out the value of goodwill, we have to multiply this average profit with the number of years purchase given in the question, and in question it is given as 3 years. So 14,000 rupees multiplied by 3 will give rupees 42,000 as goodwill. Okay, now we have to find out how much is B's share of goodwill. Okay, so B's share of goodwill is, he is going to have an equal share with the existing partner because here it is a sole proprietor and he is going to add this partner. So only now he is going to have a partner. So they are going to share equally. Okay, so rupees 42,000 into 1 by 2, you will get rupees 21,000. So this is the share of goodwill to be brought in by B. Now we'll see how much is the capital to be contributed by B. B's capital we have to find out. Okay, so first to consider this, we have to take A's capital first. Okay, because only the partners A and B should contribute equally as their capital for the partnership firm. Okay, so we have to calculate A's capital, and the same amount has to be brought by B also. So when you take A's capital as on 31st March 2020, his capital is 2,50,000, and we have to add this total profit, and we should also subtract the amount withdrawn by him. Okay, he has withdrawn rupees 40,000, so that amount has to be subtracted. So you will get rupees 2,80,000 as A's capital, which should be brought by B. Okay, so now we will go to journal entry. So he is admitted on 31st March 2020. Okay. So first, cash or bank account debit. Rupees 3,01,000, which he is bringing for B's capital account and for premium for goodwill. So 2,80,000 and 21,000 is brought for goodwill and capital. Next, he is going to pay the compensation for the existing partner. So premium for goodwill account debit, 21,000. He is paying this compensation to the existing partner, that is A. So to A's capital account, 21,000. So this is how we have to pass the journal entry for compensation. Thank you, children.